one fit to say on TV is his hope that his ex-wife's corpse was decomposing in a car trunk. Then there was Depp's personal nurse on the stand describing when she had to search his kitchen to find a chunk of the actor's severed finger, which was somehow chopped off in a fight.
And in a statement from Amber Heard herself, she describes coming down the stairs one day after Depp went 3 nights without sleeping. She says he had painted all over the walls, her clothes, everything using his own blood. Okay, Johnny Depp is on the stand now. Johnny Depp, let's listen. Why you're here today?
Yes. About 6 years ago, Ms. Heard made some quite heinous and disturbing, brought these disturbing criminal acts against me that were not based in any species of truth.
Hope you lose billions.
It was a complete shock.
Please like, comment.
That it would.
And hit that subscribe.
It just didn't need to.
It'll bring you some more. Thanks for watching.
Direction. As nothing of the kind had ever happened, though the relationship. There were arguments and things of that nature, but never did I myself reach the point of striking Ms. Heard in any way, nor have I ever struck any woman in my life.
Mm-hmm.
And so I, at the time, because the news of this, her accusations had sort of permeated the industry and then made its way through media and social media, became quite a global let's say, quote unquote, fact, if you will. And since I knew that there was no truth to it whatsoever, I felt it my responsibility to stand up, not only for myself in that instance, but stand up for my children, who at the time were 14 and 16, and so they were in high school, and I thought it was diabolical that my children would have to go to school and have their friends or people in the school approach them with the infamous People magazine cover with Ms. Heard with a dark bruise on her face. And then it just kept it kept multiplying. It just kept getting bigger and bigger. So it was my
responsibility. $15 million. I hope you lose it.
To not only attempt to clear my name for the sake of
$100 million. She's suing you for $50 million.
My children of this horrid thing that they were having to read about their father which was untrue. And also, after many years of being in this industry, at the time it was probably, I'd probably been in the industry 30 plus years, 35 years. Never had any problems. things, anything like that. And I've met many people over the years, many of the people, and had
you guys believe
the opportunity to talk to those people and to even give advice to these people.
You should get help, not advice.
I'm not, my goal is the truth. My goal is the truth. Because it killed me.
Ooh, I can lose money.
People that I had spoken with, that I had met with over the years, who maybe were in a not such a great position and they needed advice. And I gave them the best advice I could. All I could think of was that those people would think that I was a fraud and that I had lied to
them. You are a fraud.
And so I had to wait for my opportunity to address the charges, which were criminal charges. And they just weren't true. So I felt the responsibility of clearing the record as the only way that I could get to the point where I could speak has really taken this full 6 years. And it's been 6 years.